Good evening and welcome to Tucker Carlson Tonight. This evening we want to tell you a story about collusion, a real one, actual collusion that's currently in progress. There are no shadowy hackers or imaginary rendezvous in Prague in this story. There's not a single Russian spy or secret sex tape. There's nothing shadowy about the collusion we're going to tell you about. It takes place right out in the open on live television. This is a story about where your news comes from. This past Sunday afternoon, we learned that the Trump campaign did not collude with the government of Russia. That was the conclusion of Robert Mueller's investigation, an investigation that spent 2 years exhaustively looking into the question. This was very good news for America. We don't have a spy in the White House. But it was apocalyptic for the Democratic Party and their press agents in the news media. These are the people who had staked their reputations and their fortunes on the collusion hoax. And they were stunned. Befuddled politicians stammered on television trying to figure out what to say about the news. Viewers of liberal media outlets didn't want to hear anything about it. Huge numbers of them just quit watching immediately. Last night, CNN's 8 p.m. show lost nearly 50% of its viewers. For progressive channels, this was a catastrophe. Something had to be done. So into this disaster stepped the Speaker of the House, Nancy Pelosi. On Monday, just hours after the collusion story collapsed, Pelosi announced that the Democratic Party would be switching gears. Going forward, Democrats would focus intently on health care, just like, she disingenuously claimed, they always had.
Madam Speaker, did the Republicans help Democrats shift the focus here from the investigations onto health care?
We've never taken our focus away. I hope that it focuses the press on these issues.
I hope the press focuses on health care, Pelosi said. She didn't have to ask twice. At CNN, they were paying close attention to every word Pelosi uttered. To Jeff Zucker and the anchors who work for him at CNN, Pelosi isn't just a politician, she's the leader of the party, their party, the party under whose banner Zucker has said he may someday run for office. When America's most powerful Democrat speaks, CNN listens with pen in hand. These are marching orders. And the network swung into action immediately. The rundowns of every primetime show were scrapped and rebuilt. Gone were the segments about office towers in Moscow and Carter Page's spying and Don Jr. going to prison. In their place, long editorials about health care. The Democratic health care plan is sensible and necessary, CNN told us. The Republican plan, cruel and heartless. Between 7 p.m. and midnight last night, every show on CNN followed Nancy Pelosi's instructions. Every single show talked about health care, and every single one channeled Nancy Pelosi's views on health care. She could have been writing the scripts. Maybe she was. Nobody hit that topic harder than an anchor called Chris Cuomo. Cuomo is the son of the former Democratic governor of New York and the brother of the current Democratic governor of New York. He spends a lot of time telling you what a committed shoe-leather journalist he is, probably because his instincts are so obviously political. Last night, the governor's brother read his party's talking points as if off a cue card. Close your eyes as we play this and imagine you're listening to a 30-second attack ad on the radio during campaign season. See if you can tell the difference.
Our president said today that the GOP will be known as the party of health care, but it seems to me he left out a word. Based on his administration's latest move with the ACA, the president will make his party about removing health care. This president and his party have no plan to provide care to tens of millions if the ACA is gone. Why? Welcome to the new normal.
They're taking your health care away. If you're waiting to hear the paid for by the Kamala Harris for President Committee line, they left that out. They shouldn't have. The law requires it. But they did anyway. Don Lemon hosts the next show in CNN's lineup. As a person, Lemon isn't nearly as political as the governor's brother is. He's a local news guy at heart, the former weekend anchor at a station in Birmingham. He's not into policy. On the other hand, Don Lemon has a very sweet gig, and he knows it. So when Jeff Zucker calls and tells him to talk about health care, he does. And of course he did.
The president says the GOP is going to be the party of health care. Then why is his Justice Department saying the Affordable Care Act should be struck down? The president has said again and again that he wanted to protect pre-existing conditions. Is this yet another lie from the president?
Yet another lie on health care. At no point did any of the anchors on CNN yesterday mention what was so glaringly obvious. In the space of just 24 hours, that channel went from the Russia Conspiracy Network to an extended advertisement for the Affordable Care Act, as written by Barack Obama. The viewers, those who remained, must have wondered what the hell was going on. Where's my segment about how Don Jr. is going to prison? I want to hear more about that. But no. On Pelosi's orders, it was Health Care Week on CNN. And they were back at it this morning, assiduously, starting at 6 a.m. today. Every single show on CNN's morning lineup and all through the day regurgitated Pelosi's talking points to the word about health care. Republicans will make you sick. Only Democrats will make you well. Every single show made that point. If you were stuck in the airport, it was like living in North Korea. A speaker bolted to the wall above your head, blaring an endless loop of propaganda you can't turn off.
Giving House Speaker Nancy Pelosi and congressional Democrats just the opening they needed.
And it puts health care for millions of Americans in some level of uncertainty and also jeopardy. What would happen? I mean, what would happen? What would millions of Americans lose?
Just to be clear, yeah. Republicans do not have a plan to replace Obamacare.
The fate of health care for more than 20 million Americans insured through Obamacare and Medicaid expansion hangs in the balance.
As of this moment, Republicans have not offered a single new alternative to Obamacare.
Some people characterizing this as a gift to Nancy Pelosi going into this next 2020 election.
Get rid of Obamacare, says the Trump administration. Okay, so what's the plan to replace it? We don't know, says the Trump administration.
Simply repealing Obamacare without Republicans coalescing behind an alternative would throw the health care system into chaos.
That is laughable.
You read my mind. I wanted to get your respondent to the president saying that we will have a plan. Laughable. Noted.
Laughable. We have no idea what they've been showing over on CNN for the past 4 hours. We had to turn it off at 4 p.m. But if we had to guess, health care. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm getting word from our... We have a news alert now. According to our producers who are monitoring the situation, both CNN and MSNBC are talking about... That's right, health care right now. Health care. Pelosi's orders. What does that tell you? It tells you where your news comes from. Democratic officials pick the topic and the storyline. Their servants in cable news dutifully repeat it to the word all day long. CNN is not a news outlet, it's a super PAC. It is running unregulated campaign ads 24 hours a day. Someone ought to call the FEC about it.
More Mueller fallout, brand new reaction from a top Republican looking to investigate the Obama administration officials who helped launch the special counsel's investigation. Welcome to a brand new hour of America's Newsroom. I'm Sandra Smith.
How you doing? All right.
Good morning.
You're hanging in there, right. I'm Bill Hemmer. Good morning. We're now learning that it will likely take weeks, not months, for the full Mueller report to be turned over to Congress and the public. House Oversight Committee ranking member Jim Jordan demanding all documents related to the investigation go public, but not just the report itself. He also wants to get to the bottom of why the Mueller probe started in the very beginning. He said this just a few moments ago.
There was absolutely no collusion. Think about what Bill Barr said. He said there are no new indictments coming, there are no sealed indictments, there's no collusion, and there's no obstruction. It could not be a stronger, more definitive statement on this entire investigation than what the Attorney General made, total vindication for the president. And as I've said many times, totally good news for the country.
Congressional correspondent Mike Emanuel picks it up live on the Hill today. Hey, Mike, how you doing? Good morning there.
Bill, Sandra, good morning to you. Senate Judiciary Chairman Lindsey Graham says the verdict is in, but Democrats just cannot accept that verdict.
The bottom line here is that Mueller has looked at this for 2.5 years. He's concluded that no one on the Trump campaign colluded with the Russians and that the facts regarding obstruction were insufficient for him to make a decision. Therefore, there is no way you could prosecute a case if the prosecutor is unsure.
Democrats sold the American public that Robert Mueller would find there was collusion between the Trump campaign and the Russians in 2016. They told their base time and time again it was going to happen, so they are not attacking Mueller. They're expressing skepticism about Attorney General William Barr's handling of the Mueller report and deciding there was not enough to charge obstruction of justice. But Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein also reached that very same conclusion. So far, Democrats are not letting go.
I don't need Attorney General Barr's interpretation of the report. I am for the report. And our main thrust on this issue is simply transparency. release the report, then come to conclusions.
There was clearly evidence of collusion, and I want to see the Mueller report, not the Barr summary, for all of the evidence and see how close it came to proof beyond a reasonable doubt. That's the very high bar that is used to judge whether there is a prosecution.
Democrats clearly believe time is working against them. They are pushing to get the Mueller report released by next Tuesday, but all indications are the Attorney General will need at least a little more time.
Yeah. Bill, what is your sense that you're picking up, Mike, as to whether or not they keep pushing on this or whether they pivot to the issues and what's quickly becoming a campaign season?
Yeah, Bill, it seems to be two tracks at this point. There's definitely an emphasis on getting back to the agenda, talking about fixing health care in this country. We had Speaker Pelosi come out with a new plan yesterday saying she could bring down costs for health care, also help people with pre-existing conditions, basically trying to go back to the drawing board and fix Obamacare. But you've also got some folks like Adam Schiff who seem to be doubling down, who keep wanting to continue this fight. There have been calls for him to step down as House Intelligence Chairman. There have been calls for him to resign from Congress. He says, whatever, and he keeps going on, doubling down on this fight about Russia and about collusion. We'll see where it goes, Bill.
Certainly will. Thank you, Mike. Mike Emanuel there on the Hill.
You bet.
Thanks.